Hey, Billy. What are you doing?
Looking at that guy over there with an angry face.
You don't look very angry.
Do you have any idea how much angry stands cost?
Alright. So, why are you mad at the bank stander anyway?
I think it's annoying. Why just stand there, you know? Why not do an AFK skill and get some XP, you know? It's just as bad as the Eat Eaters over there.
Hi guys, it's Suomi again.
I think it's kinda cute. Two lonely gamers find each other and start a long-distance relationship, publicly sending lovey-dovey pictures to each other over Twitter for the rest of the world to see, even though no one cares. Eventually causing drama, making things awkward, fighting, breaking up, and then pretending none of it ever happened. But that's none of my business.
Good job, 7 lines in and we're already triggered half the RuneScape community.
Yeah, it's alright. And dislikes are still views. Besides, they're not as bad as the 7 sins.
The what?
The 7 sins of RuneScape. Haven't you heard?
Well, no.
What? I thought you'd noticed by now. Follow me.
Fred, where are you going?
There it is, Billy. The Book of the 7 Sins in all its glory. Still as profound today as it was years ago, when it was written by a secret council of game veterans who were tired of all the crap in the community. And now we see it here in this very library.
I can't see anything, Fred.
Oh, right. Sorry. Here.
Where is it?
Right here.
It's smaller than I thought.
Well, yeah, it's the 7 Sins, not the 95 Feces or something. Anyway, moving on. The 7 Sins of RuneScape.
You need to put on a reading voice.
Alright.
Like this?
Perfect.
Ace.
The 7 Sins of RuneScape.
Where'd the music come from?
Don't ask questions.
Alright, sorry.
The 7 Sins of RuneScape. Here within these pages lie the secrets of what are considered to be the 7 most despicable acts of treason against the RuneScape community. Engaging in any of these sins will hereby sentence you to eternal damnation, as you are renounced by the rest of the players around you, even if no one will speak up to you about it.
Oh wow, Billy. I can already tell you're a sinner.
What? No, I'm too perfect to sin.
The sin of vaingloriousness.
Nope, never mind, there I am.
JB Lover 301 was a player who was truly invested in the pastime of skilling, to the extent that he decided to embark on a quest to achieve mastery in the skill that is truly the ultimate test of your skilling prowess, fletching. Upon training, feeling the hard work that had put the sweat on his brow, he decided that before even making it halfway through his journey, that he should be recognized for his accomplishments. And so, upon reaching level 90, he decided to have a party. His friends thought that this was odd, having a party before level 99, but JB Lover 301 was blinded by the confidence he had in his so-called achievement. They came and congratulated JB Lover 301 on his level 90 fletching, but they all knew that this was a waste of time and effort, and thus, the act of having a party before level 99 was written as the first of 7 sins. The sin of exhibitionism. When Ben made his first RuneScape account, he was certain he was going to have the username Ben. To his disappointment, the username was already taken by somebody else. Ben, who did not want any other username, figured that he would make an even greater version of Ben. He would be unique and claim the attention he deserved. And thus, Ben added XXX underscore in front of Ben and underscore XXX behind it. Players believed Ben to be immature, childish, and rather annoying in chat, while Ben believed himself to be cool, unique, and totally not fat. And thus, the act of naming yourself with symbols and excess letters to look cool was written as the second of 7 sins. The sin of Machiavellianism. Fluttershy was a young man with ambitions in life. He wanted his very own party hat to keep in a door forever. But money was tight, and Fluttershy had no desire to work for more. But he knew of a way to gain more, so he arranged a meeting with a makeover mage and became a girl. Instantly, a range of sexually inactive males flocked to Fluttershy, offering large sums of gold just to be his friend. But those who knew his dark secret knew of the terror ahead for the young, unknowing males that gave away their wealth. And thus, the act of playing as a girl to obtain items for free was written as the third of 7 sins. The sin of mythomania. Eddie185 was just strolling through the Grand Exchange when in the distance he spotted an individual player offering to trim his armor. Eddie185, being the young lad that he was, figured that this was a great way to obtain the legendary black gold-trimmed armor. Unknowing of the individual's mischief, Eddie 185 gave him his armor, expecting it back. However, the player ignored Eddie 185. This made him very upset, demanding the return of his armor. But the player still would not respond. Eddie 185, at the end of his tether, did the unthinkable and threatened the individual, saying that his uncle worked at Jagex and would ban him if he did not return his armor. All the witnesses to the incident thought that scamming was pretty bad, but using such a threat was an incredibly childish and irresponsible thing to do, especially as it would risk his uncle getting fired from Jagex. And thus, the act of claiming you know someone at Jagex was written as the fourth of seven sins. The sin of megalomania. Out of thousands of players, only a handful of them wear the silver crown in-game. A symbol of champions, drowning in respect. Only the most trustworthy players hold such a badge, unless you post penguin locations on the forums in separate threads every week. Yacht 308 was one of many players who adored these player moderators, and wanted dearly to become one himself. He did everything in his power to do so. He ended his sentences in full stops, he guested Mod Nina's friend's chat and helped everyone who asked for it, and those who didn't ask for it. In fact, he was so helpful, he even added, "DM is always open," with a backward smiley face in his Twitter bio. He thought he was being super nice and friendly, and everyone liked him. But the players around him knew what his ulterior motives were. He was after power. The crown. He wanted to stand out in the crowd. And thus, the act of being a wannabe P-mod was written as the fifth of seven sins. The sin of misanthropy. World 100 was Rurali's homeworld. Not because it was the homeworld of level 3s, the best skiller clan in RuneScape that everyone wants to be a part of, but because he knew a good world when he saw one. He was also a player who currently was training Slayer, killing abyssal demons. He got his gear and headed to the Slayer Tower where a different player was already training. Unheard of! Terrible! However, this was not going to stop Rurali from training Slayer. This was his world, not somebody else's. He went up to the player and started tagging the demons, provoking the other player who called Rurali out. But Rurali was not to be told what to do, and instead of apologizing for being a little shit, he told the player to hop worlds. And thus, the act of stealing spots was written as the sixth of seven sins. The sin of delusions of grandeur, culminating in pathological lying because we can't think of a catchy name for this one, so this is just a placeholder.
Were you meant to read all of that?
Probably not.
B. Wallen was a blood fan of Zezima. All his life, he had witnessed Zezima's growth on the high scores like the legend that he was. How much he would give to one day speak to the legendary Zezima himself. But he realized this would be hard. But in order to do so, B. Wallen ended up adding Zezima to his friends list, in hopes of one day being his friend. One day, Zezima had accidentally set his private chat to on. B. Wallen sent him a message saying he loved Zezima. He was never replied to, but everyone watching Zezima's stream saw B. Wallen's message, laughing at how ridiculous it is to add celebrity players you do not know. And thus, the act of adding celebrities you've never even met was written as the seventh sin.
Wow.
Heavy stuff, isn't it? Do you know how many sins you've committed?
Well, I've done a few of those, but I'm not all that bad.
You may be a rotten person, but only the most despicable members of the RuneScape community could truly engage in all seven sins.
Yeah, could you imagine anyone actually doing all seven of them?